Well, it's time to address some of the questions that you've submitted in our chat room. This first one is from Denise Pat, who writes in, I'm trying to date, and so many of the men describe themselves as spiritual but not religious. What are they talking about?
I think they're trying to snow you.
Do you think so?
That's what it, I mean, I'm spiritual. I mean, you could be into seances, you could be a Hindu, you could be a Buddhist, you could be a Zoroastrian. I mean, you could believe in the spirits that inhabit the woods. I mean, who knows what spirit? I mean, it doesn't mean anything.
Yeah. Well, you know, I was thinking in the reverse that some of them might be saying, I don't belong to, you know, a denomination is not as important to me as my faith is important to me.
I don't think they're saying that. But no. It would be a nice thing
you're
to say. You're putting a pretty face on what I think
is a
con job. But nevertheless, it's a, I'm a spiritual person. You know, I cry when I see the end of certain movies, you know, I'm spiritual. You know, I see a war movie and at the end.
I'm moved.
Yeah, I'm moved because of the tragedy and I'm spiritual. Well, you know.
Get to know them well.
I don't think that should be the end of it all. It's more concrete than that. The devil is spiritual.
Yeah. Okay, this is Debbie who asks, at one time, my 15-year-old son professed a belief in Jesus as his Savior, but within the last year, he's been questioning the existence of God. Has he lost his salvation?
I don't think so, Debbie. If you brought him up properly, I think what's happened is that every young man would go through the question. He's asking the question they all ask, who am I, why am I here, and where am I going, and is there a God, and how do I relate to him? I mean, that's a normal question, and what you need to do is to introduce him more to the Bible. Get a translation of the Bible, like the Living Bible, that he can read, and let him read some of that. And if not that, find C.S. Lewis or some of the other books that he might enjoy reading. But this is a normal thing. I mean, you know, he's growing up, he's finding out for himself.
Yeah, it's almost a healthy transition from just being led by the faith of his parents into a faith that is now his own.
He can go to college and get under the teaching of some atheist. The next thing you know, he won't have any faith at all. Mm-hmm. But he's in a transition. But it's not a bad thing at this point. Okay.
Okay, this is Ken who writes, how do you explain when a Christian gives cheerfully but doesn't get back or asks for something in faith and doesn't get an answer? What does this say about God's promises?
How do you know it's faith? How do you know it's faith? If you have faith, you'll receive an answer. But you give cheerfully, but you don't get anything back. Well, you're not giving. I mean, you're making an investment.
Yeah.
You know?
You're giving to get.
You're giving to get. Mm-hmm. I mean, giving is, it's gone. I've given it. Gone.
Cheerfully.
Cheerfully. Hallelujah.
Yes. Yes.
But not, I'm getting and I'm counting up, it's going to be 30-fold, that's 30 times 1,000, 30,000, I give it 1,000, you know. That's an investment. Go ahead.
This is Lester, who writes, the Bible says in the book of James that God doesn't tempt anyone. So why do people pray, lead us not into temptation? Doesn't that insinuate that God leads people to sin?
There's a so-called Braid Scott difference that says, suffer us not to be sifted. And I think the idea is, please don't let us be sifted, because the sifting can hurt. And that's what, God isn't tempting anybody. No, the Lord does not ever tempt somebody. Sin tempts us. Our own desires tempt us. But let us not be sifted. Don't let us be sifted. Please keep us from those trials that will break us down.
Right. This is Matthew, who says, when Jesus said to turn the other cheek to people, did he really mean that we should let people hit us?
I had a boxing coach when I was boxing. He said, well, I'll turn the cheek, and if I'm still standing, he'd better look out. You know, but the answer is yes. The answer is we are supposed to, you know, let people, but we're not supposed to be Casper Milk Coats and let people walk all over us. But the idea is we're not trying to defend ourselves and to fight. What we're doing is recognizing vengeance is mine, says the Lord. I'll repay.